Hello, I'm the Untergeek, and this is my Alesis IO Dock, which is a really great device, and I tried to make it just a little bit better. You know, the IO Dock, you already know one or own one, of course. The IO Dock is so much better than the combination of a camera connection kit and, for example, a media adapter like this thing over here, because it's much more stable and the iPad is charged while you use it, and basically it's got everything you need, almost everything. Because, for example, what I'm doing right here now, I couldn't do it with a normal IO Dock, and I'll show you what I did to hack the IO Dock. Problem with the Alesis IO Dock is that it's got everything built in. So if you take the iPad, it's got drivers, it's got MIDI, fine with that. But what it hasn't got the connector for this A-type USB bus, only the other one, which you take for printers and which looks like this. It's a B-type connector, because basically what the designers supposed that the only thing you'd need a connector for, USB connector for, is to hook up a master to it, like a computer which you use to control the iPad. But what you can't do is let's just take an USB bus and hook up to it, because it won't work. It's not a master. It doesn't work like this. So you can't use the IO dock with a hub. Normally when you use a USB bus, you've got a computer and you've got these connectors going into the computer, which are called A-type USB connectors. They are these flat ones, you know the type. And they have to go into computer because the computer is the master of the USB bus, which means it controls it. And only with a master you can take something like a USB hub, which you can then use to hook up other controllers, like, for example, let's say my small USB keyboard down here. And basically this is how it works. If you've got an iPad with the camera connector kit, very same thing. You know that the camera connector takes these A-type USB connectors, so again the iPad is our master, and we can take this USB connector and hook up another USB hub to it. So here what we're going to do, we're going to take the iPad out of the IO dock, so to speak. We'll patch up the connection and smuggle in this USB hub in between, which allows the iPad to be master once again and allows us to take this connector to patch in. This IO dock on the side has got additional USB ports down here, three additional ports, and I'm using one of those ports to connect my Axiom driver keyboard and power it up. And if you have a look at another app which is just as brilliant, it's called Loopy, and Loopy is going to show which apps are actually connected. We're going to ignore that. You see not only the dock but also the Axiom controller, which is locked in by a USB. And if I'm going to take even two more MIDI controllers, just going to put them in with the others, you can see that it registered even more MIDI in out. So once you made up your mind, you got to ignore the bullshit warning. There is no shock hazard with this unit. It's only got low voltage, so come on, what are you afraid of? Okay, let's go on. You just remove the screws and then you can just open it up like this. And you see, we've got it all cut out. We did this with a Dremel, and to be honest, the Dremel doesn't bring out the best in men. It brings out my Walter White side, as you can see in this picture. But anyway, there it goes. It's not very nice, and if you are amongst those who say, no, I don't want to do this with my IO dock, that's perfectly fine with me, and I can very well understand it. So what we do now is we put in the prepared USB hub, which is only the connector and the PCB board and the connector we soldered to it. And this, we're going to take out this here, and we're going to plug in just like this. Take this in here. Now the other way around. And then we've got this other piece of connector, which you've got here, and this is going in here. Just let's have a look. Is it the right way around? Yeah, it's just like that. And so there's one thing left to do. We'll take some hot glue and basically just glue in the whole USB port. Just a bit more to go with this. And this is, of course, not the most stable of connections, but it's fairly sufficient. So, as you can see, there's hardly any evil mad science involved here, apart from the Dremelin part, that is. There are a few important notes, especially in concerning power consumption of the iPad and of the hub. You can find that and a detailed description of what I did step by step over in my blog at www.untergeek.de. Thanks for listening.